Percy Jackson and the Lightning Thief is the first book in the fantasy series Percy Jackson and the Olympians, which talks about the Greek gods and mythology. It is written by Rick Riordan and published on the 1st of July 2005. It has many spin-off series, also written by Rick Riordan, talking about other mythologies such as the King Chronicles, which talk about the Egyptian gods and mythologies, and the Heroes of Olympus, which talk about Greek and Roman mythologies. Two outstanding qualities about the book which set it apart from other books are its simple writing style and its light humor, which is present everywhere in the book, like the chapter titles, the fight scenes, and especially when Percy is describing or explaining something. Now I'm going to talk about some scenes that I really liked from the book, so if you haven't read the book, spoilers ahead. The first thing I'm going to talk about is the fight against the Minotaur. The fight was really exciting and I really liked it. It was definitely one of my favorite fights in the whole series, and I preferred from the lackluster fight at the end. The second scene I'm going to talk about is when Percy's father is revealed to be Poseidon. I heard that a lot of people thought it would be Zeus, but actually Rick did a really good job of foreshadowing it. Especially in the first chapter, he dropped a lot of hints about Percy's father being Poseidon, which I think is a really solid twist. The third scene I'm going to talk about is the introduction and the twist about Ares. He is introduced as one of the Olympians, and he acts to be one of the friends as one of the allies of Percy. But later he turns out to be the villain, which was first thought to be Hades. My only complaint about this twist is that Rick Riordan did not foreshadow this enough. If he had foreshadowed it, it would be very good. The last thing I'm going to talk about is Luke's betrayal to Percy. In the beginning of the book, when Luke is first revealed, he is revealed to be a good character and one of Percy's friends. But when Percy is going on a quest, he offers him a gift of flying shoes. But it turns out that they were a curse, actually, and they were supposed to lead Percy into a trap, which then reveals that Luke is actually a bad guy. I really like this twist, as it was not expected at all. Overall, my conclusion is that the book is a great first book and that it sets up the series in a nice way. It's also a great way to get introduced to the Greek mythology, as it makes you want to learn more and more about it. My placement for the book is that I would say it's my second favorite in the whole series. Stay tuned to find out what my favorite is. Okay guys, that has been it for my Percy Jackson and the Lightning Thief review. I hope that you enjoyed it, and if you did, please tap the like button and subscribe to find out what my opinions on the next books in the series.